Okay, get ready to start this workout. It's a low impact cardio workout, so that means no jumping at all. You don't need any equipment, no exercise mat, no dumbbells, body weight only. We start with a short warming up. So step in front and step back. Just to warm up a little. Then we go over to the main workout. The main workout consists of 3 rounds, 5 exercises, and the 5 exercises are repeated once. Just step, step, step back. We stay on the right feet, in front, and back. Upper body is straight, move your arms along, and we switch over, left step. So this workout is no jumping exercises, so it's ideal for you if you are a beginner or if you're looking for a recovery workout, active recovery. So we're going over to the side step and arm swings. Step from side to side, just swing your arms front and back. Keep swinging your arms, stepping, just to warm up a little, loosen up the muscles, getting warm a little bit, get a heart rate up a little. The main workout consists of 3 rounds. After each round, you have a short water break. Short water break will be 25 seconds, but if you need a longer break, you can just hit the pause button and take the break, whatever you want. Now we're going over to a little bit of stretching. Come into that wide stand, one hand in your waist, body one is up, and bend over to the right side. Feel the stretch in your waistline all the way up. Make little pulses. And move over to the other side. Up and over. Bend to the side. And one more time to the right side. Up and over. Bend and make little pulses. Feel the stretch. And one more time back to the left side. Bend over. Okay, we stay in that wide stand just a little bit wider. And then it just pulls from left to the right side. Not too deep, just a little. 1, 2, and to the right. 2, left. Yeah. Upper body straight. Just pulls from left to right. Keep going, little pulses. And come up, and we finish off with the stretch of the calf. So place 1 foot to the back, press your heel into the floor. Feel the stretch into your calf. Upper body is straight. Just press your heel into the floor. Feel that stretch, and if you can, just push your hip a little bit more forward, and you can feel the stretch in your hip as well. Okay, and move over to the other side. Place your other feet to the back. Press your heel into the floor, hip forward, upper body straight. Just feel that stretch. Press your heel into the floor and release. Okay, shake out your legs, Take a short sip of water and get ready for the first round. Okay, get ready for the first round. 5 different cardio exercises, no jumping, 45 seconds on and a 15 seconds active rest. We start with a skater and a floor touch. So get ready and step to the side, cross behind and touch the floor to the other side. So we go from side to side, step to the side, cross behind, go down, touch the floor with your fingertips. That's the exercise. Step, cross, and touch the floor. Seconds. Keep your back straight. Just lean over so you can touch the floor with your fingertips. Down and up. And we go for the last one. And then you have your active rest. And the active rest means active, so stay active. Keep walking, tapping. And the next exercise you're going to do is a front kick. You don't have to kick high, just as high as you can. So come on and kick and kick. So you walk back, switch over to the other feet and lift your leg up in the air. Hop, kick, switch and kick. Kick up. Keep your upper body straight up and just swing your leg up in the air. Up, left, over to the right. Almost there. Last one, and go over to the active rest again. The next one is a sumo squat, wide stance squat. You don't have to squat as deep, go as deep as you want. You don't have to go deep at all. And when we go up, make a side raise with the arms. So come into that wide stand, make a squat, come up side raise. Squat, side raise. That's the exercise. Make sure you press your knees a little bit to the outside when you squat down, so do not collapse your knees in. And make sure your butt is going down. Squeeze your butt when you come up. And bring your arms up on shoulder height. Hop. Upper body is straight. Working the glutes, the shoulders, and of course, heart rate is up because we're going up and down. Use the muscles. Hop. Almost there. Last one. Down and up and go over. Active. Next exercise is a side step and a front step. So you step to the side, tap. Step to the side, tap. That's the exercise, just follow me. Get ready, step to the right, hop and step front. Left, front, right, front, left, front. I press my heel into the floor when I tap in front. Heel, heel. And when I do that, I bend my standing leg a little. Ha, tap, heel, tap, heel. Yeah, you got it, come on. Keep your upper body straight and move your arms along. Step and heel. And we go over to the last one. And active rest. Okay, one more exercise. We finish with the twisting curls. So we twist in, make a bicep curl. That's the exercise. And then we're going to repeat the 5 exercises. So, okay, ready? Twisting curl. Twist. Curl. So you twist in, tap your toe on the floor. And when you do that, make a bicep curl. And when the bicep curl, upper arms are still. Just moving your underarms. Upper body is straight, chest is open, shoulders are low. Come on. Twist and curl. Curl. So you twist in all the way from the left to the right side. And 10 seconds left. Feel the tension in your bicep. Make fist. Power in those curls. And the last. last one. That's it. Active rest, and we're going over to start again with the skaters and the floor touches. So we're halfway on the first round. Keep on moving. Get ready for the skaters and start. So cross behind, tap the floor with your fingertips and move over to the other side. So step, cross behind, and go down, touch the floor with your fingertips. And make sure your butt is going down, and do not lean over all the way like this. Butt is going down, so you can touch the floor with your fingertips. Just a few more. Go in for the last one and have your active rest. Next one is the front kicks. So you swing your leg up, step back, up, and swing on the other side. Get ready, start with the right and kick, step back and switch. Just kick up as high as you can, and if it's just below the floor, it's good enough. But try to kick high. Up. Come on, walk and kick. Almost there, just a few more kicks. Up. Kick, and the last one, kick, and that's an active rest. Okay, going over to the sumo squats and the side raises. So if you can squat deep, it doesn't matter, just go little pulse and up, just a little. Come on, into the wide stand and go down, come up, raise your arms. Hop. Make sure upper body is straight, shoulders are low, chest is open, just go down and up. Press your knees a little bit to the outside. Feel that in your outer thighs as well. Come on. Down and up. And 15 seconds left. Down and up. Squeeze your glutes. Up. On shoulder height. And the last one. That's it. Okay, we're going over to the side step and the front step. And the front step, we do that with our heel on the floor. So stay active, don't stand still. Keep moving, get ready, and go. So right, heel, left, heel. So when I step to the left, my right heel is in the floor. Move your arms along. We have to get the heart rate up a little. Come on. A low impact doesn't mean your heart rate can't get up. Come on. Step, hop, step, tap. And bend that standing leg when you press that heel into the floor. Almost there. We do one more to the right, and that's it. Okay, we finish the first round with a twist and the bicep curls. After that exercise, you have your short water break. And then we go over to the second round. Second round, 5 complete new exercises. So get ready, twist and curl. Remember, upper arms are still. Just moving the underarms. Bring your fist towards your shoulders. Hop. Working those biceps. Twist in and tap. Twist and tap. Twist and tap and curl. Come on. A few more seconds. Keep the power in your arms. And we go for the last one. And that's it. Okay, have yourself your short water break. And make sure you drink enough and get ready for the second round. Okay, give us ready for the second round. 5 different exercises, new exercises. We start with the windmill touches. We step out and touch the inside of our toes. And then come back up and switch over to the other side. So come on, follow me. Arms up, step out. Tap your toes on the inside, step back out. And switch over to the other side. That's the exercise. So step out, touch your toes on the inside. And up. And if you can't touch your toes, just tap your knees or your calves as far as you can go. But try to challenge yourself. Go deep, go down, and touch your toes. Arm up and switch over. Out and tap. Almost there. Last one. Step out. And that's it. Okay, stay active between the exercises in the 15 seconds rest. The next one is the back tap repeated. We do about 20 seconds on one side. We just step back and press our arms in front of us. So get ready and go. Tap back, press your arms in front. Your upper body is straight up. Arms are on shoulder height, chest is open. Tap and press. Make sure your standing leg is slightly bent, working the quads as well. And one more on this side, and switch over. Keep that standing leg bent. Press out your arms all the way, stretch out your arms. Make your arms long, and hands back to the chest. Come on. Stay down, keep that standing leg bent. And the last one, that's it, come up. Okay, stay active. Next exercise is the lunge pulse. So we come in kind of the lunge position and just pulse. About 20 seconds one side and then we switch over. So come in this position, get ready and just pulse. Up and down. Find your balance. Keep your upper body straight and just go down and pulse yourself back up. Okay, one more and switch over to the other side. Left leg in front and pulse up. Up and down, squeeze your glutes. Come on. Almost there. And that's it, come back up. Okay, next one is the sidestep deadlifts. We just step to the side, make a deadlift, so fingertips are going to the floor, come up and set by. And then we switch over to the other side. So come on, step out, bend over, fingertips still right above the floor, come up, press your hips forward, and then step out again. So we step out, make the deadlift, and come up. Great exercise for the hamstring, the glutes, lower back, and of course, a little bit of the heart rate, because we're going to bend over, come back up, step out, all together. So come on, step out, bend over, reach down as far as you can, and up, down, come up. Just a few more. Down and up. And we go for the last one. Down, up, and have your active rest. Okay, final exercise of the second round is the low butt kickers. So the standing leg is bent and just kick your butt with the other. 20 seconds one side, so come on and kick your butt. So standing leg is bent, upper body is straight, find your balance, engage your core, and just bring your heel towards your butt. Repeat that exercise. Up. So kick it. Stay down. One more. And switch over. Come on, no rest. Just going over to the other leg. Up. Make sure it's bent. Working the quads. Come on, kick your butt. Few more seconds. Stay down, don't come up. And the last one, kick, and that's it. Okay, we're going to do the 5 exercises again, starting with the windmill touches. So we're halfway to the second round, that means halfway in this workout. So come on and start. Step out, tap your toes, come back center, switch over to the other side. So step out, twisting your upper body, touching your toes on the inside, come back up, bring your hands back on shoulder height, and step back out. Bend your leg when you step out, reach over and tap. Just a few more. Come on, step out. And we go for the last one. That's it. Okay. Going over to the back tap repeaters. 20 seconds one side, 20 seconds on the other side. So get ready. And start. So standing leg is bent. Tap back. And press your arms in front. Upper body straight, shoulders low, chest is open. Come on. Belly button is in, engage your abs for finding your balance. One more, switch over. Come on, stay down, don't come up. Make your arms long, press as far down as you can. Ha. And the last one. That's it, come up. Okay, going over to the pulse lunges. So stay active, don't stand still. It's not allowed in this workout, just keep moving. Okay, come into that lunge position and start pulses. Up and down. Squeeze your glutes. Keep the upper body straight. Stay on this side. Almost there. And the last one, hand switch. Keep going. Just right into that pulse again. Down and up. Come on, a few more seconds. And that's it, come on up. Okay, next one is the side step with the deadlift. We start in a few seconds, recatch your breath a little, keep moving. Okay, get ready and start. So step out, make the deadlift, come up, press your hips in front. Up and front. You touch the floor with your fingertips just between your toes and come back up. And if you can't touch the floor, just go down as far as you can. And come all the way up. Up and down, touch the floor, come back up. Keep going. Just a few more. Last one. That's it. Okay, you're doing great. Next exercise of the second round. We finish with the low stand butt kickers. And then you have yourself another short water break. So come on down. Bend that standing leg and kick your butt. Just bring your heel up. Keep that standing leg bent. Working your quads. Come on and kick it. Stay on this side, stay down. And the last one, and switch. Come on. Stay down. Bring that heel towards your butt, kick it. 10 more seconds, stay down. Almost there. And the last one. And that's it. Okay, have yourself another short water break. And get yourself ready for the final round, round 3. Okay, round 3, final round, 5 different exercises. We start with a double low sidestep, and when we are at the end, we come up, swing our arms out. Just follow me, go down and shuffle, shuffle, come up and down to the left. Doubles, up and down. That's the exercise. So we stay down, when we walk to the side, come up and down. Double, up and down. Up and down. Squeeze your glutes. Go down. Shuffle to the left. Come up. Shuffle to the right. Come on. Down. Up. Down. And the last one. Double. Up. Down. And active rest. Next one is a side lunge. And when we come out of the lunge, we pull our knee up. So it's a little bit complex exercise, but we're in the final round, so we can challenge ourselves a little bit more. So come on, I start with the left, out, up, lift your knee up, and up. So out, bring yourself back up, find your balance, lift your knee up, and back out. Come on. So squeeze your glutes, press yourself up, and bring your knee up, up. Come on, we stay on this side for the whole 45 seconds. We will do another exercise and then we switch over to the other side, the right one. Up, come on, just a few more. Step out, lift your knee. And one more, out, come on up, and that's it. Okay, next exercise. So standing mountain climbers, arms are up, and we lift our knee up, pull our arms down, and just switch. Okay. Get ready, arms up, and start. So pull your arms down, lift your knees up, and make sure your knees are at least on a 90 degree angle. But if you can, try to lift your knees up all the way to your chest. Keeping your upper body straight, so we do not lean back. Do not lean over, just straight up. We pull our arms down and lift our knees up. Keep going. 15 seconds left. Power in your pulls. Hop, hop, come on. And the last one, that's it. Okay, very well. You're doing great. Next one is the side lunge with the knee up on the other side. So I go with the right. If you started with right, then you do the left. So come on and start. Lunge to the side, knee up. Knee up, and down. Press yourself up, find your balance, lift your knee. Come on, keep going. Down and up. Come on, press yourself up, lift your knee up. Keep your back straight. Just a few more. Up. down. Last one. Lift up, and that's it. Okay. One more exercise. It's the jack steps. Then we're repeating the 5 exercises. And then you're done with this workout, and we finish with a short cooling down. But first, jack steps. Step out, arms up in the air. No jumping in this workout. So just step out, pump those arms up all above your head, and lower down. Left, right, left, right, come on. 15 seconds left. Tap out, arms up, just a few more. Last one, and lower your arms. Okay, repeating the 5 exercises, starting again with a double low steps, up, down, and a double. Okay, get ready. Start, down, and go. Double, up, down, double. Up, down, come on. Stay down during that walk. Hop. Up, down. Only come up after the double sidestep. Up, down. The deeper you are, the heavier it is. So come on, challenge yourself. Double. Up, down. Almost there. Up, down, last one. Up, down, and that's it. Okay, going over for the side lunge. I start again with the left. So, to the lunge, knee up. Come on, stay active. Get ready, and go. So, side step, lunge, knee up. Press yourself up, use your glute, lift your knee up, tap, find your balance, and just go again. Come on. Up, down. Squeeze those glutes up. Come on, you can do this. Don't give up. Just a few more reps on this side. Up, down, and the last one, up, and that's it. Okay, going over to the standing mountain climbers. So we catch your breath a little, and we're going over, pulling those arms down, lifting those knees up. So arms up and start. Power when you pull your arms down, come on. All the way up and bring those arms down. Lift your knees up as high as you can. Not just a little, all the way. Come on, give all you have. Ha. Power in those pulls. 15 seconds left. Just a few more. And the last one, that's it. Okay, 2 more exercises, then you're done. Finish with a short cool down. Going over to the side lunge on the other side. I do it the right one. So get ready and go. Step out into that lunge, come up. Down. Up, press yourself up, using your glutes up, squeeze it. Come on, lift your knee, find your balance. Come on, keep going. You can do this, don't give up. Step out, lift your knee, just a few more. up, and we do one more, up, and that's it. Okay, we finish this workout, round three, with the jack steps. In a few seconds, so stay active, get ready, and go. Tip as far to the side as you can. Bring your arms up all the way above your head and lower it down. Come on. Full range of movement. Hop, hop. It's the final exercise, so finish strong. You can finish this workout. Hop, tap, tap. 15 seconds. Almost there. Keep pumping those arms up and down for the last one, and that's it. Okay, well done. You finish this workout, we're going over for a short cooling down. Okay, short cooling down, just to get the heart rate down. Step and swing, cross your leg behind the other, and just make simple arm swings just to release the tension out of your body. Recover a little bit. So, keep breathing in and out. Just step, cross, and swing your arms. Release the tension. It's always good to finish a workout with a cooling down. If you have a workout of me in the playlist and there is no cooling down or warming up in it, please make sure you do a single warming up of cooling down. I have some of those on my channel as well. Okay, keep over to the side step, arm circles, circle to the front. And circle to the back. Big circles. Release the tension in the shoulders. We did a lot of movements for the shoulders, presses, arms up and down, all for the shoulders. And of course, we worked out our glutes, our quads as well. So we're going over for a little bit of stretching of those muscles. Okay, we start over with a bend over stretch. So place one hand in your waist, just one arm up, just bend over and feel that stretch. Keep breathing in and out. Get that heart rate down. Little pulses and go over to the left side. Hands in your waist, on your hip. And then bend over, feel the stretch in your waistline. One more time to the right side. Little pulses. So we did get our heart rate up. We worked out a lot of our muscles, only almost total body workout, and that with no jumping in this whole workout. So you did a great job. Keep on stretching over. And release. Okay, we're going to stretch our upper body. Rotations. Swing over from the left to the right side. Okay, and we're going to do the shoulder stretch. So one arm is going in front, grab your elbow and press it towards your chest. Make sure your shoulder is low, and then you can feel the stretch of the shoulder and a little bit of the shoulder blades. Just hold it a few seconds. Okay, release. Over to the other side. Bring the arm towards your chest and feel it stretch into your shoulder. Just press your arm towards your chest. Okay, and release. Okay, quad stretch, so find your balance, grab your ankle, bring the heel towards your butt, hips push in front and knees together. Oh, I'm going to fall. Find your balance, I said. So, And then feel the stretch on your upper leg, your quadriceps. And just hold it a few seconds. So bring your knee backwards as far as you can, hips forward. And then you can feel that stretch. And release, going to do the same on the other leg. So grab your ankle. Bring the heel towards your bent knees together, hips in front. Press your hips open and bring your knee back. And then you can feel that stretch on a quadricep. A few more seconds. Okay. And release. One final stretch for the calves and the hips. We did it. So press your heel into the floor. Press your hips open forward. And feel that stretch into your hip, into your calf. Upper body straight up. And just hold it a few seconds. Okay, and switch over to the other side. And of course, if you like this workout, please hit that subscribe button if you've already done that. I have over 500 workouts on my channel, so there's definitely one for you. If you like those low impact workouts we did today, make sure you check out the playlist with the low impact workouts. There are a lot of it in the playlist. Leave a comment behind, let me know what you think of this specific workout. And come on, get up. Well done, you finished this workout, and I'll see you next time.